and it is he who sends the winds to disperse before his mercy.
So is that the same as tomato and tomato?
Look.
Is that the same as tomato and tomato?
No, it's not the same.
Thank you very much. Don't believe that.
No one's denying there's different qira'at of the Quran. No one is denying that. It's been brought, everyone knows this. It's only, let's say, Dr. Zakir Naik is saying it to his crowd.
The New Testament is full of fabrication.
Don't go to the New Testament.
The whole
okay, let me explain the New Testament.
The New Testament is
when,
full of
when God gave the New Testament, he gave it in different aruf and different qira'at. Okay. That's why we have different versions. Are you going to accept that?
The Saudi Quran is the right Quran, and it's the Quran that we read every day.
And what
day.
About the other one?
I'm going to call my dad is on the phone, yeah?
Okay.
Show me the verse.
All right. You ran away. What happened?
Basically,
you had the runs.
Basically, what happened last week, yeah, to all the viewers on Soko Film. Hello to all the Christians out there. Love to all the Christians. You know, I've got love for you, yeah. It's your boy Modin Dunno. Big up Paperboy. Big up the real ones out there. Yeah?
Okay, it's medication time now.
Hey, chill yourself. Basically, Alhamdulillah, Min Shaitan Ajim, Bismillah, Ahmad Rahim. Paperboy, basically, yeah, last week, Sambo was a fight, so I had to go, but I wanted to come back to speak to Paperboy, yeah?
Yeah.
Basically, before I'm going to ask these questions, but I do want to...
Did Uthman change the Quran,
believe? Let me explain what happened.
Burning stuff changes it quite a bit.
No, let me explain what happened. Basically, when the Quran, the Prophet Muhammad, some of the scholars say, in the time of the Prophet, it was compiled. Some of the scholars say, no, they differ. They say, after the Prophet died, Imam Ali, alayhi salam, the cousin of the Prophet, Imam Ali, and the 12 Imams, So Imam Ali compiled the Quran, and the 12 Imams, they kept it safe. What happened was, the Muslims...
But then how come there's confusion?
Let me explain. So what happened was, Imam Ali, he compiled it in order. Anyway, the Quran we have today, we accept it.
Is it the original
Imam
Quran?
Imam Sadiq says, اقرأوه, Imam Sadiq says in Al-Kafi, اقرأوه كما هو.
Yeah, but is that the original one?
Yeah, yes.
Because you said Ali's name, wasn't it? No, you said it was taken out.
Because when Ali's name, because هذا صراط علي مستقيم. Imam Sadiq said, because the dots, when did the dots happen? In the time of Uthman.
Yes.
There was no Fatha, Kasra,
Dhamma. Well, after Uthman.
Yeah. So after Uthman, then they brought the Fatha, Kasra, Dhamma, so the people can repeat.
Okay.
What I'm trying to say is that the Quran we have today, I believe is 100, and the scholars...
But was Ali's name in the original one?
Yeah, the name is there.
Is it still in today's one?
It's still there. If you bring me the Quran, هذا صراط علي مستقيم. But because we don't read it as علي مستقيم, هذا صراط علي مستقيم. Because the Imam Sadiq says, just read it how it is. We don't want to read it how it is. But what I'm trying to say, so the Quran we have today, the Saudi one, is 100% from Allah, and it's 100% correct.
But what about where Umar said we have missing parts of the Quran?
Yeah. So basically, like I said, according to Bukhari, Aisha narrates this, but we do not take this hadith. We say this hadith is wrong. So they believe that the Quran is missing, but we don't believe it's missing. Do you understand? But what I'm trying to say, Rabbah Soko, is that in the time of there was, if you read about
it. So where did the differences come in the reading?
I wanted to say to you one more time, read. Listen to Dr. Ammar Naqshawani. This is...
But where did the differences come from?
If you listen to...
Were Muslims corrupting the Quran?
Okay, no. Let me explain to you what happened.
Right.
When the verses came down, they always brought two witnesses.
Okay.
To say, are these verses correct? Did you hear this in the time?
And this
of the
is
Prophet?
From Sunni hadiths.
No. This is what I'm telling you from the hadiths. What I've read is that when they say the Quran, they brought two witnesses.
Yes.
Just witnesses to say that they've heard this in the time of the Prophet, because they've got to send people to areas to recite.
But that doesn't make sense, because if the Quran is a linguistic miracle, you wouldn't need two witnesses, because you would know the eloquence of what they're saying can be from another.
What I'm trying to say.
The Quran says, make a surah like this? Yes. No. That means the eloquence is so high, a human cannot copy the words of Allah.
Yes.
Copy the Quran and make a fake version. They can't make a fake version because their eloquence will not be the same. So you say people... So you say people can corrupt the Quran?
No, there isn't.
But I've given you... Okay.
Yeah, but you're not showing me the
Okay, go on, go on. Continue. Continue. So they needed two witnesses. Because the problem is, when you go to the hadith, there's a hadith where it says that Umar knew the verse about stoning.
Yeah.
But because he was the only witness, they did not include it in the Quran.
Let me explain.
So this is a verse that was omitted.
Let me explain to you. Yusuf, just come please, because this is my brother Yusuf, he became Muslim. Come here please. Yusuf, run. Yusuf, I want you to come here. Do you know why? Because you're the true face of Islam, not these.
Because people. He wants you to explain the Karat and Aruf. Because he's going around in circles. You see another reluctant person.
Ya Muhammad! Ya Muhammad! Ya Muhammad!
Yusuf, Yusuf.
Alright.
So we got our brother Yusuf, he's from Italy and Russia. He's a from a Christian to Islam. But listen, I believe in what you believe in, I believe in what I believe in.
I don't believe in Quran.
No, one second. I believe what came down to you, I believe what came down to me. Your God and my God are one. Do you know, listen.
Stick to the Quran, explain in the
form. I just want to say something.
Don't divert.
No, no, you know in Bukhari, you'll never read stories about Jesus. But where will you find stories about Jesus? Read Al-Kafi, read Bahar al-Anwar. These books from Ahlul Bayt have hundreds and thousands of hadiths on Jesus. I just wanted to say this. Because Jesus, if you go to the Muftar al-Sunni books, the hadiths, they don't have hadiths on Jesus. They don't narrate from Jesus. We have from the Imams, from the Prophet Muhammad, thousands of hadiths from Jesus. You know Jesus has hadiths. All right, I'm going to say that to him. Jesus has hadiths. But I just wanted to say,
okay.
Do you know, I just want to say the Christians out there, because they're lovely people, the Christians out there, the most humble people, Allah says in the Quran, don't forget what Allah says.
Tell us about the compilation.
Okay,
tell us.
Okay, I'm going to tell you about the compilation.
All right.
But one thing I wanted to tell you before anything, is that we take from Al-Kafi. So if you want to read, if you're taking hadiths from Bukhari, I'm not taking it.
Do you accept the Al-Kafi where he talks about the chain of narrators being
Al-Kafi,
donkeys? Do you accept that hadith?
What does Al-Kulaini say? Al-Kafi, kafi li shi'atina. It's enough.
Do you accept that hadith?
Huh?
Where Yafur is a narrator of a hadith and the chain of narrators is donkey, going back to the time of Noah.
Yeah.
Do you accept that hadith?
Okay, I'm gonna come back to that. I'm gonna be honest. No, in front of the camera. If there's something I don't know, I have to say I don't know. I have to go back to it. I'm not a scholar.
You know that hadith.
No. I have to go back to.
There's a chain of narrators from Yafur all the way back to Noah.
Yeah.
And all the donkeys are the narrators.
All right. Let me explain. One second. All right. No. I've read the hadith. That there was a donkey at the time of the Holy Prophet, and he spoke to the Prophet. He said, "I was in the ship of Noah. He was the descendant of the donkey that was in the time of Noah's ark. You know.
So how do you know if a donkey is trustworthy?
One second. You know the Noah's ark. They brought the animals to save them. Yeah. No. They have to bring animals so the animals survive, because everywhere got flooded. The Chichimans got flooded. Yeah. So what did Prophet Lot do? Prophet Lot. No. I'm just saying. Because I'm coming to the donkey.
All right, go.
Prophet Lot said.
Yes.
Everyone bring two animals, like you know the animals on the ship, so the place gets flooded, so the donkeys can live on. That donkey that was on the ship, he had children. Do you understand? He had children, and the children stayed with.
How do you know if a donkey is trustworthy?
Listen, I'm not talking about that.
But how do you know if they're trustworthy?
I'm not talking about that. What you're talking about. I'm talking about another story.
Stick to topic.
Because I said I don't know about that one.
Okay, let's go back to the compilation of the Quran.
No, I'm talking about.
Let's stick to the compilation of the Quran.
Okay, but I just want to say.
Let's stick to the compilation.
Right, I just wanted to say to the.
Because that's something else.
I just want to say to the Christians. Let's
stick to the compilation of the Quran.
All right, we're going to stick to the compilation. Regarding Ammar Nakhshawani, I've told you Christians to go and listen to Ammar Nakhshawani. He is one of the top scholars, Muslim scholars out there. No one's ever heard of him. No one's talking about him. Why? No, we've heard of him, but he does. If you will listen to one of his lectures, you'll become Muslim today. What today?
So, what does he say about the Qiraat and Aruf?
Okay, what he says, let me explain to you.
Yes.
Dr. Ammar Nakhshawani says, he says, linguistic. Like, Yusuf, you want to say something about that? Just let Yusuf say something. Because he hasn't said that. Yusuf, Bismillah, Tawakkal ala Allah, throw the chunga.
You read Arabic? Okay.
No, Yusuf, just speak out the chunga.
Yeah. Because the argument that Muslims will use against the Trinity is that it goes against sound reasoning and intellect. If you go to a five-year-old and ask them about God, they will not come out of the Trinity. So we are using that same criteria to say about the preservation of a Quran. If you go to a five-year-old and say, describe to me what you would think a perfectly preserved book is, would they come up with Qiraat, Aruf, changes here, changes there? So this is why we're questioning, does this go with sound logic and reasoning? So if you want to tell us
just before we go into that point, that hadith you mentioned about the donkey narrators.
Yes.
According to your own logical beliefs about God, don't you believe it is possible donkeys could do that according to your logical...
That's
an Ashari hadith, but...
Yeah, there's no such thing as a chain of narrators of donkeys.
But is it possible?
Is it possible? No. not a chain of narrators.
So Jesus can be, God can become human, but donkeys can't talk to another donkey.
If God made it happen, but you said you believe it happened.
I don't believe.
Okay,
no.
Then we can stick to.
I just just want to know. Like,
God can make anything happen. Mm. But no one here believes that donkeys are a chain of narrators, because how do you even know that donkey is trustworthy? And don't divert, because he asked you a question. No, because you're trying to divert. You see, he's trying to divert. No, no, stick to the topic of the Quran and the preservation.
God can do anything.
Stick to the topic of the Quran preservation. You see? Can you tell us about the Quran? Yeah, go on.
Okay. So, what do you know about?
Can I just say the donkey thing? I got it here. Basically, Imam Ali said, the first one of the animals which died was Yafur, who died within the same hour that the Messenger of Allah died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He broke off his bond until he began to run, until he came to the well of Banu Qatam and Kuf, and threw himself into it and gave his grave. It is narrated that Amir al-Mu'minin,
so the
Imam
donkey
Ali
killed
said,
itself.
One second, Imam Ali said,
is that what he's saying?
The donkey spoke to the Messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, may Allah take my soul and the soul of my parents in service for you, for your cause. My father related to me from his father, from his grandfather, from his grandma, who lived in Noah in the ark, who lived with Noah in the ark. Once Noah came to him and whipped him on his back and said, from the descendants of this donkey, there will be a donkey on whose back the master and the last of the prophets will ride. And he said, I thank Allah who has made me that donkey. This is the chain of narration, and this is the hadith, it's in Al-Kafi, go and read it.
So how do you know if the chain is trustworthy?
I'm going to tell you how the chain is trustworthy. I'm going to tell you
donkey,
how
the, anyway, but yeah.
That's the hadith.
So tell me about the Qira'at and Aruf, because it doesn't seem to make sense.
I mean, you kind of have something similar within Christianity. If you look at all the English translations of the New Testament, the meaning of the verses are the same, but the words are different.
So is that your understanding? The meaning has to be the same?
In the Quran, it's a lot less. The differences are way more less compared to, let's say, New Testament translations, where we've got verses with at least five different words, but the meaning is still the same.
The meaning doesn't change.
So, I mean, this whole concept.
Okay, so this is what I brought people.
Already as well.
This is Surah Al-Araf, and this is what I've been asking all day. So one in the half says, and it is he who sends the winds as good tidings. And in the wash it says, and it is he who sends the winds to disperse. Now, this is what Muslims would try and use and say Maliki and Malik, where it's king and owner. They'll say that's the same thing. Here we have two totally different meanings. So what
no,
you said
totally
doesn't make sense.
It's the same meaning, but the Egyptian Arabic.
Is a glad tiding the same as to disperse?
You know the Egyptian Arabic and the Saudi Arabic? It's just the linguistics. The word is the same. The word is the same, but it's just the linguistics. It's the linguistics. The Quran is preserved, alhamdulillah. And no matter how much you try, and that curse David Wood, he put me on his channel.
So you're saying glad tidings is the same as to disperse?
What, to disperse something? If I've got bottles of water and I disperse it to the crowd,
yes.
Is that a negative connotation with disperse?
How is that? How does the meaning?
Let's teach you some English.
Wait.
Simple.
The meaning of disperse is not.
Let's go to English.
We're asking. Is the meaning
already.
Of the word
your English wait. Is problematic
I'm asking,
already
I'm asking is the meaning of the words the same, because when you say Maliki and Malik
now I know what you're trying to do. No one said that when the two different words are used that the words are going to have the exact same definition, but the verse in general, the meaning is still the same. To disperse something and to give something in good tidings.
So,
according to
so now that means English, now that means you have more than
English.
One Quran,
I mean,
because if there
no, no, no,
because
one Quran,
the original narrative was every single Quran was letter for letter, word for word, dot for dot.
Mary and say, I bring you disperse.
Hold on. You see that? One second.
Okay.
You know there's Egyptian Arabic, there's Saudi Arabic.
Going back
it's
to this
not, it's the same meaning.
Arabic
is one.
Yeah, the Arabic is not the same.
Right, going back
and,
to this
come,
point.
And
second,
I'll give you another
second,
example.
One second. Going back to this point that there's only one Quran. I'm not involved in the movement that was using that as a way to say that we don't.
You don't
no
believe
one's
that.
Denying there's different Qira'at of the Quran. No one is denying that. It's been brought. Everyone knows this. It's only, let's say, Dr. Zakir Naik is saying it to his crowd. Let's be honest.
Okay. I'll bring another problem. For example, here in Surah Ghafir 40:26, Allah is quoting Pharaoh, but we see Pharaoh say two different things. So how can you historically quote someone and the person says two different things?
Read it out for the camera.
So it says, and Pharaoh said in the house, let me kill Moses and let him call upon his Lord. Indeed, I fear that he will change your religion or that he will cause corruption in the land. In the Wash it says, and Pharaoh said, let me kill Moses and let him call upon his Lord. Indeed, I fear that he will change your religion and that he will cause corruption in the land.
The same. When Yadhar, and here's when Yadhar. Oh, and Yadhar.
Right. So when, now it's either he's going to do one or the other, or he's going to do both. But if you're quoting Pharaoh, a historical statement, if Allah is all-knowing, how can he then misquote what the Pharaoh said? Because Allah knows what he said.
First of all, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
والقرآن.
وأن يظهر, and that's where, أو أن يظهر.
Yes.
Yes? What did the Muslims, let me just say to you, the Muslims, the Quran today, the Saudi Quran, is in Saudi, that Quran is the Quran that we follow. You understand?
Yes.
This is the Quran that we follow. Regarding other people who speak...
In Morocco, for example.
He's not from your culture. He's in Morocco, another accent. I'm going to say they, because remember, when the wars happened in Islam and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam died...
Because Morocco wasn't speak Arabic before.
Again, this is not answering the question. My question is, if Pharaoh said something historically, how can Allah misquote him?
No, he never misquoted it.
Because he cannot say two different statements.
No, 1 second. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will never misquote something. It's 100%. If someone did do something, like someone who's got another Quran version, and he wrote something.
So you're saying someone changed it?
Hatun, la'natullah alayhi, and David Wood, they're putting holes in the Quran.
This is why we have holes.
1 second. They're putting holes in the Quran. Does that mean she brings
that's
it, the
Quran? That's
got
nothing to do with what I'm talking to you about.
If someone has printed a Quran, and he has put a word.
Not a word, just a different vocabulary.
He'd put a different. It's the same word. It's exactly the same word. It's 100% the same. There's no different meaning. It's just like, how can you say pronouns? I got a C in English, I should have got an A, but anyway. It should be like, you know, pronoun, vocabulary, adjective and all that. It's just that, it's like, how can it, you know when you've done poetry, Romeo, Juliet, you know.
See,
about
he's
that.
Not explaining
second,
it, and this is why
I'm explaining it.
We have Romeo, holes no, it's in not the standard holes. Narrative.
You know Romeo and Juliet, is it the same as reading Harry Potter? It's not, it's different. Romeo and Juliet is the same thing. For example, if Romeo, oh, what's that guy's name? The Shakespeare. Oh yeah, Shakespeare. Sheikh Zubair, yeah? Anyway, Shakespeare, yeah? If he said something and someone said something, but it's exactly the same meaning, but Shakespeare says it in a different way. Do you understand? But I'm not trying to say he said it like that. But do you see what I'm trying to say? Do you see what I'm trying to get?
No, I'm on the topic.
All right, now, to get back to the topic.
What I'm trying to say, now I'm trying to say. Don't believe, look, what I'm saying, look. The Quran is 100% preserved. Imam Sadiq said, "Iqra'u kama huwa." Read it how
so,
it is.
So which but, which version okay, is on, I'm telling on the you eternal
I'm,
tablet?
I'm telling you.
Which
Quran
one is on the eternal
in Saudi,
tablet?
The Saudi Quran.
So are you rejecting the Moroccan ones and all the other ones?
It's exactly the same.
I've just shown you the difference.
The Saudi Quran is the right Quran and it's the Quran that we read every day.
And what
day,
about the other one?
And it's never been changed.
And what about the other ones?
I've told you. The other ones is a Quran is exactly the same. But according to them,
yes.
There's a, how can you say pronunciation, like, you know, comma.
I've just given you an example.
No. According to them, the way they read, the way they've read
so
it.
So one reads glad tidings and the other one means to disperse.
I'm just telling you, the 100% Quran is the one that we have in Saudi Arabia, and it's never been changed, and it's okay, and read it how it is.
So are you saying the other ones have been changed?
No, it's not been changed. There's no change. But it's exactly the same.
No, you just said the one in Saudi Arabia has never been changed. So are you saying the ones elsewhere have been changed?
Rabbi, let me give you an example. You see this guy, he's got...
Yeah, answer
one
that
second,
question.
I'm going to give you an example.
Let
you
me see, let it make
one second.
Sense.
I've got a beard here, yeah? You've got a beard, yeah?
I've got a beard as well.
Exactly, you've got a beard. Now, if you say he's got a beard, that means you've got a beard, for example. I've got a beard. But I don't really have a
how
beard.
How does that answer the question about what Pharaoh said?
I'm giving you an example.
I'm asking
if
you,
I said to
it's
you,
been 5 minutes.
If I said to you, cut your beard, for example, yeah? And then I cut my beard, I just got a little bit, and he cuts his beard. He's telling you cut your beard. You're trying to say, oh, Moses, because Pharaoh, do you know what I'm trying to say? You're trying to play with the thing.
I'm not playing with the thing. Yeah, this is what your Quran says.
Look. This is the right one.
How do you know this is the right one?
Listen to what I'm saying. Pharaoh, when he said, let me kill Moses, what does he say? I'm going to translate it to you. And Pharaoh said, let me kill Moses. Yeah, this is in the Quran.
and let him call upon his Lord. Indeed, I fear that he will change your religion and that he will cause corruption in the land. Okay? He will cause corruption. What does it say? In your religion, or that he will cause corruption in the land. It's the same thing. He's saying the same thing.
No, and or is not the same thing.
It's the same thing.
And or is not the same thing.
Okay, one second. You're gonna come just for this little thing. And you're gonna leave the whole. The New Testament is full of fabrication.
Don't go to the New Testament.
The whole
book
is fake.
Okay, let me explain the New Testament.
The New Testament is
full of fabrication. When God gave the New Testament, He gave it in different aruf and different qirat. Okay. That's why we have different versions. Are you gonna accept that? Exactly,
that's the same thing they say about the Quran.
Notice the double standard and the hypocrisy.
No,
because every version is from God. Okay.
No.
Can you read Arabic? Can you read Arabic?
Tell him, speak it.
Can you speak Arabic?
No, but okay. You are wrong.
Can you speak Arabic?
No, but you are wrong.
Why am I wrong?
Because the differences in the Bible are actually...
Don't go to the Bible.
No, no, no,
okay.
Don't run away.
We're talking about the Quran.
The Quran. Yeah. It's just to do with... It's like if you live in like Manchester and you have a word for potato in Manchester.
Like potato and potato.
Like that.
Yeah, all right. Potato like and that. Potato. Tomato and tomato, right?
In all of the Qirat.
Okay, now here's two versions of the Quran.
Don't run away from the New Testament. Don't run away.
Because she's now defined what is the difference. It's tomato, tomato, potato, potato. So I'm asking you, here we have Bushra, Nushra, yeah, as a good tied-in to disperse. Is that meaning
number
the same?
Number one, I'm not going to look at the English because the English is...
Yeah, read the Arabic.
The Arabic says Bushra.
Yeah.
And this says Nushra.
Is the meaning the same?
I don't know the Arabic. Does anybody speak Arabic here?
Sorry, you... You see?
Okay.
Every time... You see?
Go back to it. Please go back to it. Please.
Okay.
I just want to have a look at that.
Listen, I said to him, there's a secondary science. Which is...
You were still looking for the dictionary definition. Don't come to me. No.
You
spent 10 minutes looking for the definition and then you ran away.
Muhammad Hijab does a really great one on the Qirat on YouTube.
I've seen it. It doesn't make sense.
Right. And it is he who sends the winds as good tidings before his mercy until. And it is he who sends the winds to disperse before his mercy.
So is that the same as tomato and tomato?
Look.
Is that the same as tomato and tomato?
No, it's not the same.
Thank you very much.
No, but
that's what you said originally it was.
Okay. There's Malik and there's Malik.
That's not what I'm asking.
Okay.
Here,
okay,
you said tomato, tomato,
no,
and you agreed with it. You said
tomato.
Potato and potato.
Okay,
same. Now I've destroyed that because Bushra and Nushra, you've agreed, is not the same.
Okay, tomato, tomato, no. Okay, look, you've got Malik and Malik, and one means owner and one means...
But
king.
I'm asking as glad tidings and
so here,
to disperse.
You've got as good tidings before his mercy. You see how they've got the words mercy in there? And then you've got to disperse before his mercy until...
So what if Allah had come to Mary and said, I bring you to disperse, instead of I bring you glad tidings? Would that make sense? No.
No, what you
because
should
the meaning
do,
it doesn't...
if you want to get Muslims
yes.
in something, then you should bring the meanings of those two words.
The meaning's right there.
No,
good tidings and
no.
to disperse. Because this is translated by Arabic.
Yes,
by Arabic scholars.
Some Arabic scholars, and not all of them are English speakers. Okay.
The Arabic scholars who can translate into English.
Okay, but...
Don't throw them under the bus.
Wait. Some Arabic words, I don't speak Arabic, but some Arabic words have multiple meanings.
Okay.
I'm going to call my dad is on the phone, yeah?
Okay.
Show me the verse.
All right.
We're
going to...
My dad is on the phone.
Papa Modin. Papa Dean. He was going to give us... Let's see our Papa Dean.
Listen, اسمعني. هو الذي now do you want the fair one? Bring me the fair one. Or do you want the which one do you want?
That's fair is fine.
شوف. قال وقال فرعون دروني أقتل موسى وليدع ربه إني أخاف أن يبدل دينكم أو أن يظهر وأكو قراءة الورش يقول وأن يظهر في الأرض الفساد. فقرآن في قراءة الحفص يقول أن يبدل دينكم أو أن يظهر في الأرض الفساد وفي قراءة الورش يقول أخاف أن يبدل دينكم وأن يظهر في الأرض الفساد ليش
Does he want to take a 50-50? Ask a friend.
يقول he says the same thing is the different accent. It's the different,
different dialect.
It's
yeah,
the dialect.
But the meaning is the same. Huh? Tell no, Papa Dean to come and we will show him.
I get his point.
But the problem is, Allah is quoting Pharaoh. So this is a historical statement.
The text is the same, but
so how can there be variations in what someone said historically?
No.
Look, and Pharaoh, listen, and Pharaoh said. That means this was a true statement in history. Not even trying to describe Allah like Allah is a king, Allah is an owner. If you are quoting someone, they cannot say and...
Can I just say something to all the Christians?
Kill Moses and let him call. Oh, yeah,
I beg you, let me say something. This is better than everything you're saying. Listen.
Wait, let the lady...
That's
yeah, but there is or that and that. And means both. Or, what does or mean? If I say to you, would you...
Or.
Thank you. Yeah, and and means...
Also.
Both.
Yeah.
Thank you.
To us, in English.
All right.
Yeah. To us in English, yeah. That's gone.
Okay, so now we clearly see.
Okay, so I fear that he will change your religion or that he will cause corruption in the land. I fear that he will change your religion and that he will cause corruption in the land.
Right.
Okay.
And so now you're quoting someone historically.
Yeah, yeah.
So how can he have two different statements?
I understand you. Because the thing that is with the Qiraat, you need to study the Qiraat deeply because of the fact that there are different ways of saying things in different lingo.
So there's different ways of misquoting someone.
No, okay. I just want to say something.
Yeah. Wait, let her finish,
Look, there's different lingo, different ways that people say it.
Because if that was in the Bible, they will say it's a contradiction straight out. But now we're seeing the gymnastics of trying to explain it. When they first she said potato, potato was the same meaning. And she agreed on it. Tomato, tomato. But when I gave Bushra and Mishra, that doesn't go with what she said. Now she's trying to reinterpret it. Now this is why Yasukadi said there are holes in the standard narrative. Because it doesn't add up. The first question would be, who would be the seven people that were given a recitation?
Listen, no one knows. I just want to say one thing.
Yes.
About Jesus, yeah, to the Christians out there that claim to love Jesus. Listen to Imam Ali in Nahj al-Balagha, how he describes Jesus. Quickly, just 1 minute, 1 minute. I'll be on a finish, 1 minute.
So we'll conclude.
He said Jesus laid his head on a stone, put on dress made of coarse material, took tough food. His main diet was hunger. At night, the moon provided him only light. During the winter, he slept under the sun. At times when it shone or set down, his fruit and vegetable was none other than what the earth grows for animals. He neither had a wife that could cause, that could instigate him to do.
What is the point? This is taking too long.
Nor did he have any property which might have taken him away from God.
What is the point you're trying to get to, Mr. Modin?
Nor he had any kind of greed for the world to think that could cause him humiliation. He had no means for moving except his feet. His servants were his hands. Now, Jesus is very humble. You understand? The Prophet Muhammad was humble. Their cousin. Now the same Mrs. Jesus, he's a humble man. The Christians, they're not following Jesus. The Muslims, they're not following Muhammad. You are not following Jesus. Muslims here, they're not following Muhammad. Both of you are being ignorant, and you're claiming to be Christians, and you're claiming to be Muslims, and you're both wrong. That's what I want to say. Both of you, you're misguided. Because the Jesus said, after me, follow Simon. The Christians didn't listen. They didn't follow Simon. The ones that followed Simon, they will go to heaven. But the ones, and the Prophet Muhammad, he said, after me, follow Ali. They didn't listen to him. The ones that followed Ali, they'll go to heaven. I just wanted to say, if you were at the time of Jesus, you should have listened to Jesus' advice. I just wanted to say, don't believe the Muslims today, the hadith books is lies, and don't be one like them.
The same hadith books you went into to quote that there was two people, reciters, two witnesses. You're picking and choosing the hadith.
A lot of Christians will be in hellfire. A lot of Muslims will be in hellfire because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the Christians will be split in 72 sects and the Muslims in 73 sects. Only one will go to heaven in
each sect. Which is the one in the Islam?
Okay. The Prophet Muhammad,
and that's a hadith.
Let me say, the Prophet Muhammad said, he hit Imam Ali's chest. He said, the ones that follow Ali will be in heaven.
But that's
he
not
said,
in the same
he said, 12 of them, he said, 12 of them will claim to follow Ali. 11 won't be in hell. Only one of those 12 will be in heaven. But like I said, pattern up, and I've got love for you, but follow the truth. And when Jesus comes back,
and until you explain to me the difference between the Quran,
that's not
to know the truth, you need to know which Quran it is in the truth.
Rabbi,
at the moment, we have hundreds of Quran.
Your Bibles, there's hundreds of different Bibles. The New Testament is full.
You have just agreed that there are different Qurans.
No, there's no different Quran.
Yes, you did.
One Quran.
No.
One Quran.
What is the Harsher Quran?
No,
is the Washer Quran?
No.
Is the Washer Quran?
It's just a vocabulary in one word.
With different meanings.
But you've got the New Testament.
happening?
A whole book is with, false.
Okay, let's
the
go.
New Testament.
Let's go
the
to
New
the head. Wait.
The New Testament is not from Jesus. The New Testament is misguided. It's made by men to misguide people. Jesus, when Jesus comes back, he's going to burn the New Testament.
Let's
when
see
Jesus comes back,
the compilation
he's going to kill the swine.
Of the
when Jesus comes back in a couple of years, maybe two or three years, I believe, he will even break the cross. He will say, I am the king. And follow and worship Allah, but we have to follow him on this earth as with Imam al Mahdi.
Okay, now look.
Do you know who's Imam
al-Mahdi? Wait, look.
The mother of Imam al Mahdi, her father is the king of Rome, and her mother is the descendant of Jesus. So this is Imam Mahdi who will come and rule with Jesus.
Wait. This is from your sources, yeah?
Yeah.
They say because Uthman messed around with the Quran, his body was thrown in the garbage for 3 days. Because of what he did to the Quran.
Yeah.
And they say, look, because he wasn't buried in the Muslim cemetery, isn't it?
He was
buried
with the Jews.
Thank you. So the place was hush where they answered the call of nature. It is called the toilet.
Yeah, he's buried.
So
in the toilet.
They say this was the Muslims revolting because he had changed the Quran.
Okay, basically what Uthman did, I'll tell you what he did.
Right.
He said ban every Quran except for the Quran that there's a long story. I have to take
all right. So there was differences and that's why they killed him.
No, there was no difference. I have to get back to you on that one.
All right.
But what like I said, the Quran was compiled by Imam Ali and Imam Ali, he's the one this Quran is correct.
I want to look at it.
Do you need any question?
No. If you give me a second, I'll give you my email then I can I'll have to send it to you. Then you can verify it.
Yeah, I'd like to check them and find out about them. Yes. And one of the other ones is interesting to me and I want to check it.